Hello everyone, and welcome to Cats Gaming. Today, we are diving into Subnautica. Now, this is a game that I'm sure most of you have seen being played by Jacksepticeye or Markiplier, and to be honest, I actually started showing interest in this game while watching Markiplier. I love the ocean. I wanted to become a marine biologist when I was younger, so, you know, it just really captivated me to see all these cool new life forms, and obviously hearing that, I have played this game before, but as you can see, Castles and Coffee update, I've not played this game in a very, very long time. They've come up with updates constantly, and I think that is one of the coolest aspects of Subnautica, is that I'm with it growing. I'm watching it change over time, and with that, I gotta get right into it, guys. I want to see what's new. That's new. All right. There we go. Totally good.
Greetings, survivor. Great job not dying.
Oh, thank you.
To assist you in further survival in emergency situations, you have been issued this personal data assistant. The interface visible now will organize your inventory, display currently available construction.
Ooh, this has changed.
And holds other valuable information. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with it.
Oh, trust me, I'm familiar, all right. This, though, this has changed. It used to look a bit more simplistic, but...
Local radiation levels. Trend is consistent with ongoing degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core due to damage sustained during collision. Continuing to monitor.
Alright. Alright, let's see. This is new. Ping Manager. Ooh, this is something I really wanted. Before. What? Something I really wanted beforehand. You know, I've also never understood hatching enzymes. I don't think I could create it at the time. But they were implemented into the game somehow. Probably just their icons. But, God, it's been so long since I've actually played. Let's go outside. Ugh. Oh, this is it's oddly nostalgic, actually. It feels so refreshing, really, to be here. And I fucking hate you gas mask motherfuckers, but it just, I don't know, if you guys have ever been to the beach or anything like that, you know, a lake, and you know that feeling of just that
oxygen.
Uh-oh. I forgot about that. Yeah, that's important. But how that like cold water just enwraps you, envelops you. Well, for me it's kind of like that whenever I go in here. Cuz it's the safe shallows, right? It's safe. It's nice. It's good to you. Unlike my parents. Just kidding. My parents are good. My parents are cool. Quartz is cool too. Alright, you know what? Let's go see if the Aurora has changed in any aspect. I'm sure it has, for sure, but... Oh, man, I can only imagine. Huh. No, that looks about the same. Well, there's the creep vine. Alright. Oh, alright, and... Alright, cool. As you can see, there is no land for miles. And miles. But, thanks to this thing, we can actually survive.
Site materials, 19%. If the drive core is breached, probability of death increases to 65%.
Oh god, okay. I want to say that was also part... Oh, no! You stay. you stay. Go fuck yourself. Ooh. Those are crash fish. And, basically, they're homing torpedoes. The crazy little fucks will blow up on you. And does Gary make a noise? He does. Did he used to make a noise? Uh-oh. Oh, he sounds so cute. Hey, buddy. Do you? Nah, you don't make a noise. Ooh. Oh, and then these guys. They're pointless. You can't eat them. They don't hurt you. They're just kind of there. But, what's the point of having a fire extinguisher underwater? What? Alright, hold on real quick. Let me get some bearings. And, let me get some stuff going on. Hey, welcome back. Alright, so, check this thing out. Ooh, fancy. So basically, this will help you, the viewers, because I know everything about this game, let's be real. It lets us scan stuff.
Local radiation readings exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core. A quantum detonation will occur with a probability of 85.5%.
Okay.
A 1 kilometer safety range.
1 kilometer. Okay, so, if you haven't figured it out, and I think I said it, but this actually updates our data bank. You could actually see, you know, the anatomy and, you know, like what the PDA has to actually say about these foreign creatures. I always thought that was such a cool idea that the game developers had made. And it was also one of the things that really led me to playing this game, was the fact that they put so much time and investment and thought, just the imagination of everything, into this game, that I thought, you know, I gotta try this. To put that much time, dedication, effort, I don't know how big the production studio is, but I can't imagine they're, you know, like, making triple A's. Like, if they are on the side, I'd definitely like to play that. But, no, just for the scale of this game, which I think it was, like, I want to say $20 on Steam. 15, oh, that's new! Oh! Wait. Oh! Uh-oh. Hey, buddy. Hold on. I just... Alright, thanks. Uh-oh. Oh! Oh, guys.
Oh,
I gotta go. I gotta go!
Five, four,
I gotta go check this out. now if that was not fucking awesome. You might have dulled your senses and you live a boring life, but to me, that was fucking awesome. Like, come on. That, the fucking wind just whipping in your ear, and that explosion, that, oh my god, everything about that, when I first played this game, it was exactly like that. Maybe not exactly, I'm sure they added a bit more dynamics to it. But other than that, no, like, that's just how fucking cool this game is. It's always made me just so happy to see, you know, all these new interesting things. They've always got something hidden away, it seems like. And yes, I have played to the point where obviously they didn't have anything new, but they came up with more stuff. And that's why I always kept coming back, you know? And that's why I hope you guys will keep coming back, because I want to discover this stuff as much as any other person who's interested in this sort of thing, you know? Yeah, you know what? Oh well. Yeah, no, like, I really want to share this kind of experience with you guys, with anyone, you know? Which is also why I started up, YouTube. Because I don't know, I kind of want to see, I want to share my experiences with people, and I want people to be there with me. And Shuttlebug. Uh-oh! Ha! Hey! The Shuttlebug's not useless, it lured me to my death. Just kidding. Oh, and then bladderfishes are by far one of the most important fish, next to peepers. Because they are a huge source of water. You can turn these poor guys into water. You could even scan metal salvage. Which actually, this game has a huge, huge story behind it. Which is another thing I love about it. This game is nuts. Ooh! Oh! The blinker! Oh, it's different! Oh, that's so cool, the pinger. The pinger is different, guys. It's sturdy, it's blue, it's not constantly flicking like sonar, which, I mean, I didn't mind that, it made sense. But at the same time, I like that steady kind of hold on it. Makes me feel a bit more secure. Before, in the game, you would always constantly get lost. It was almost ridiculous, like you couldn't tell which way was up or down, and, well, I mean, like, that's how it is if you go diving and stuff, but, it was a bit of a struggle, for me as a beginner, unfortunately. Alright, I'm back. It's morning, thank god. Usually I to wait out the night, I made an oxygen tank and this thing. It's the small things that really make it though. And then they changed it. Oh no way, dude. Oh my god, that's awesome! Oh my god, that's sick! Okay, wait, so you see the bottom icon? That is what this thing in my hand originally looked like. You kind of held it at that middle point where it kind of constricts. And you just right-clicked, and it would help bring you up to the surface. Whoa, that's even faster too! I don't know if it's just me or if that's actually faster, but this thing looks sleek as fuck, dude. And let's just see real quick. I want to see. I'm not pressing anything else. Nope, that is definitely faster. This thing has saved my life so many times from drowning, and it's saved me from a lot of hairy situations. And I'm so glad to see it actually, you know, get an upgrade, get an update. Rabbit rays are one of my favorite animals on this fucking planet. They're the cutest, by far. Come here. I need you. Alright, you're cute. But, Yeah, for now, we got a knife. We got an oxygen tank, if you notice in the bottom left. We have an O2 gauge, which was, I think, 45, I want to say, or 40. Now it's 75. Huge difference, huge upgrade. And now we also have a knife, so we're gonna cut some creep vine because that is. Oh, that's how I. Ooh. Ooh. Oh! Oh, hey. Oh, you scared me. Fucking cock.
Kill me.
Uh-oh. Yeah, so there's also these guys. Uh-oh. Hold on. Okay, hi. Sorry, I'm back. And, where was I? Oh, yeah. These guys. These gas mask-looking motherfuckers right here are called gas. Yeah, alright, not gasopods, but gas. Gastropods, gas. Whoa, actually, you know what? That bucking is kind of new. Don't think I've seen it before. I kind of want to see if they have an updated thingy entry. These fucks killed me at least twice, and I had no idea because, well, I just swam through a cave opening and into a pocket full of that shit and died pretty much instantaneously. So if you can imagine how much fun I had with these guys, you can understand why I hold them in such a, high view. How I view them to be just the best. Oh, hoop fish, or hole fish? What? I have forgotten everything, people. Holy shit. Other than that, I don't want to make these videos too long. I don't want it to be, mostly just me swimming around because that's what it's gonna be. I'm gonna be cutting out a lot of material. Well, I say material, really, I'm just cutting out a bunch of junk. Oh, that's different looking. Oh no. Never really used it before. But yeah, no, I just don't want you guys to sit here and watch me play a video game. Nah, I just don't want you guys to watch the boring parts. So I'll be doing a lot of farming on the side. And so if you're like, "Oh, what the fuck? How do you get that shit?" Well, you'll know. It's because I farmed for it. And you guys got to miss, I don't know, 30 minutes, give or take 30 minutes of me swimming in circles. Yeah. Oh god, you guys missed out on so much. Yeah, no, I've read about updates beforehand. It doesn't really make much sense. No, whoa, buddy. Bad dog, bad, bad. Fuck off, bitch. Alright. Oh, they're a little too close. Ooh. But yeah, no. I just. Whoa, I fucked up. I'm sorry. Wait, I don't have the thing. I don't have the thing. Ah! Stay away! Okay. Alright, well, you know what? Fuck that. I used to not be afraid of you guys, but, you're more aggressive than I remember. Oh well. But yeah, I think actually I'll just, I'll get a few more things, and I think I know what I'm gonna do for the next episode. All right, but hold on to your seats, guys. I'll be right back. Right, Mr. Stalker? Right, puppy dog? Oh, fuck you. Oh, there's another. I'm sorry. Wait, hold on. Okay, now I'll be right back. No, now I'll be right back. Motherfucker. Fuck off! Jesus Christ! Oh, my heart. God damn it.
30 seconds.
Oh, 30 seconds to suck a dick. God damn, stalker. Oh, my chest. Ow. You cock. Do I have time? Oh, nope. Fuck. Gotta go fast. Gotta go fast.
Oxygen.
Uh-oh. Air bladder. See, guys, it is useful. Yeah, buddy. You raise that up in the air. You raise that. I was gonna cut this part out, but I guess not. Now, I'm looking for lead. And silver. Silver and lead. Lead is actually almost useless. And I hate it. Because I don't use... Well, I'll get to that in a future episode. But, I always need silver. Everyone will always need silver. Oh, this is a stalker tooth. Okay, that is very good, because those are really tricky to harvest. You legit have to rip them out of the mouth of a stalker. Yeah, that's right. You actually have to fucking fight a stalker and knife the fucking teeth out of... I'm just kidding. That's not what you do. You just basically play with him until he, you play with the stalker until he loses his tooth. Because, you know, they lose their teeth like sharks, I guess, whenever they bite things. And, one of those things, that they love to bite is metal salvage. So I will legit pick up a piece of metal salvage and go play fetch with a stalker. Wait, hold on. Let's see. Oh, radiation! No! This is exactly what I want the lead for. Go away. Okay, wait, hold on. Lead. Damn it. Where'd my knife go? Knife? Oh! Fuck off. Ah, fuck! See, I knew it! God damn it, I fucking called it. You cock. That's why they're called stalkers. Just they fucking come out of nowhere and bite me in the ass. It's a really long story, don't ask. Whoa! What? What? Did that... Are those babies? Those are babies! Stalker babies! Aw, buddies! Wait, alright, stop. Like... I'm just trying to... Ah! Fuck off! Fuck off! I just want lead! Cock! Shit! Fuck you! I swear to God, if I die... If you guys make me look like a fool... More than I already am, so... I'll fucking kill you! God damn it! Ah! I'll be right back. Ah! Okay, so you know how I said... harvesting stalker teeth was a huge problem? Well, that's why. Because these assholes just love to bite. Oh, shit. Give me lead! God damn it. Well, it's getting dark. I just wanted one thing. But I guess I'll have to just... go out of my way. Oh! Oh, there it is! Wait, don't bite me. Nobody bite me. Nobody bite me. Okay. Okay, I got it. Hey, what up? Watch me drown before I get there. I could just totally forget I had to breathe and drown, but it's whatever. It happens every now and then, right, guys? Okay, so the moment I've been waiting for to end this video properly, I should say, is not magnesium, but that's going to be in something in the future. Radiation suit. Alright. Now then, with this, we got the radiation helmet, the radiation suit, and the radiation gloves. Don't know if you guys noticed, but I kind of got hit with some radiation back there, and you heard, you know, I've never named her. What should I name her? PDA. We'll just name it PDA for now. I'll come up with something cute or cool. Who knows? God, that's beautiful. But yeah, no. So, with this, I can get closer to the Aurora. And, I don't know how many of you guys, well, I'm sure those of you who do play know about this, but for those of you who don't, we'll be taking a trip to the Aurora once we get all stocked up on supplies. Because trust me, we're gonna need it. But other than that, guys, this is Katangaroo wishing you all a very happy day and a happy night. Cat out.